Okay, so the basic idea of what we are going to do today is building a very simple SPML model and then visualize the graph in Cytoscape. And the two main things I want to show is basically how we can build such models with SPML utils, and afterwards how we would analyze and visualize them in Cytoscape.
Hello.
So what is SPML utils? It's basically a set of utility functions and a Python module with this utility functions, which allow to easily build new models. And what it does is giving an abstraction layer around around SPML and provides helper functions to easily build such models. So what we do now is basically just create a new model. In this case, you would just create a simple tissue model for the liver, and then analyze this model in Cytoscape. So what we do for that is first in this PKDB models, we just build a new package. We'll then just build a simple liver model. What I'm doing right now is I'm just copying an existing model, and we'll just adapt this to our needs. So this is basically what we have here, and then I will just remove everything for now, and then I can explain step by step what we're doing here. So what we are importing is basically a few tools or a few functions from SPML utils. This is SPML model creator, and it's basically the model creator, the factory, some helper functions for the units, and some helper functions to work with annotations. In addition, we import a few other things, but I will just include them here directly so we can see this. It's basically the units and so on we don't need. What we also define or import is here like a bit of unit definitions. So normally for SPML, we don't need units really for our model. We could create a model without units, but it's best practice and highly recommended to just put units at all variables, parameters, species, reactions, and so on. And this allows basically to do unit validation and later on also to automatically convert experimental data to the units we have. So what we do here in the first step is basically defining a new unit definition. It's just defining a unit which is called liter per minute, and we defining basically the liter and here the minute, which is 60 seconds. And this port argument is not so important, but it's just basically saying we can reuse this later in the model coupling. The other thing we're doing is basically defining now here a list of units where we use units which are already predefined, and add additional units which we need in our model. In this case, we adding this liter per minute unit. The next thing, like basically every model has a list of units, and then you also define like what are the model units I want to use. So basically the main units you have in there, it's like what units are your time in. Like if you have a dynamic simulation, what does the time dimension mean? And the other things are basically for the length units, area units, volume units you have in a model, and extents and substance means basically if you have species in there, or like species which have a certain amount, in which units will this be measured. And normally what we're doing, we have worked with chemical substances. We're measuring this somehow in mole, and we're using normally millimole for this. So most of the models, I would say millimolar and minute is a pretty good starting point. But it depends a bit on the model. I would just not change that here. The next thing, this is basically the whole unit definition part, and this looks a bit complicated right now, but you only have to define the units once, and then you just reuse them in the model definition. Next thing we do is basically give a model ID. In this case, it's diazepam, a model for diazepam in the liver, and then we have to create basically all the model objects we have in the model. This is the model units we have already in there, and the units we already have in there. So basically, can do this here. And the idea is basically you have like one Python module where you define certain lists, and this list then like created basically as objects in the SPML model. So in this case, we have the units, the model units, and a model ID which we defined. And this was just an additional helper unit we defined so far. Okay. So what is in a model? Normally we have compartments in a model. This is where all the species are defined or located. And we have species. These are basically the species or compounds we have in a model, and then we define the additional parameters and reactions which are, can convert the species between each other. So in this case, we first define the compartments, then the species, and then the reactions for the model. Because here we not modeling the whole body but only the liver. We basically just interested in a liver volume. This is here. I create a list of compartments, and then I put a compartment in there, and this compartment is identified by an ID for liver. I give a certain size. Yeah, it's 1.5 liters, and I can define basically some annotation terms. Okay, what is this? What does it mean, this compartment? In this case, it's the physical compartment. And just give ports. The ports, especially if you want to couple this model later on, and because we want to couple this model to the whole body model, we have to create ports for all the things we want to couple later on. And what we couple normally is basically all the compartments, or like the external compartment and the liver compartment. So these should both have ports which are true. And then we're putting basically species in the liver model. In this case, yeah, we have to put in the species for our diazepam model. So for that, I will just quickly look up what we should put in the model. One second. Let's basically figure out, okay, what are the main reactions and main species I would need to model this. And okay, for this, one second. Just close everything here. Okay, for this we will basically look up some information which we already have for the model. In this case, we did a bit of literature research and basically have some basic understanding of what is the main metabolism which is happening in the liver. In this case, for the diazepam, it's converted to three main substances. Like there's a demethylation step, a hydroxylation step, and here another, like two hydroxylation and one demethylation step. And the main step here, diazepam is primarily metabolized by CYP, and this two CYPs to the major metabolite, desmethyldiazepam. And this is basically what we now will model in the model. This very simplest part. Diazepam is via a demethylation converted to desmethyldiazepam. We'll just copy that here. I just put this up here in a general comment. This is what is this? This is a metabolic model of hepatic metabolism of diazepam. And here diazepam is primary metabolized and may active metabolite. Just putting this in here so that we have it as a as a reminder. What we need to model this is, of course, the diazepam and also the desmethyl diazepam. So we will add this as species to the model. So we need diazepam. I'll just call this diazepam for now. And we can give a name, diazepam. And have to put this into a compartment. In this case, like I just say, we have external diazepam. And the external is here normally the external is, I would say that it's the blood compartment, or it's normally what we couple to the blood compartment. So it's the external volume around the liver, and this is normally the blood. So this is the diazepam in the blood, and we do the same basically for the desmethyl diazepam. So we call this DM diaz. This is the desmethyl diazepam. So pretty easy. We just need the species, have to give some initial concentration. We say everything is zero, and then put this here in the external compartment, and we will do do something similar now for the other compartment, our liver. It's basically putting this in the liver. Und Diaz here. Putting this in the liver. And then just writing in the name the liver so that we see later on that this is really the liver species. And this basically, I would say, I remove everything else here from the model. This is basically already like a very simple model. We don't have any conversions or reactions in here. What we just did is we created two volumes, created units, and used this unit somehow here, for instance, the unit kind liter, and for our species, for instance, the substance units, unit millimolar. And then basically have a function to create this model. Okay, just have to reference the right module here. This is the diazepam, model liver, and so on. And this basically just referencing this file here. Just saying it's in the PKD model, it's the diazepam, it's in the PKDB models, diazepam, model liver. This is basically the model we want to generate. We can then call this create function with a target directory. This is basically the first model definition, and then we now only have to create this model. And this we're doing via basically a simple model factory. Just add this here. Factory. This is basically our idea. Our model factory. And here we are just importing our liver model, because this is basically the only model we want to create right now. So we're importing from the diazepam right now. Diazepam, our create liver model. And then have a helper function which creates all our models. In this case, it's only our liver model. Okay. In this case, I will just remove most of this. The only thing we want to do right now is create our liver model. And then we just have to say where we want to save that. And this we want to save here in the folder models. So it's just a subdirectory of here. So we will store the resulting models in a folder down here. Models. Okay, I'll just say 1 second. And that's basically all we do here. We just say, okay, this. We're doing not much here. We're just having a function which calls this create liver model function, which we imported. Just import this here, create liver model. And this is basically this function here, create liver model. And this is just using this module to create the SPML out of this file. And that's all we do. We'll just execute this and see if this works. No, it's got a wrong argument. Okay, so we see now what happened here is basically that this model was now successfully created. And it was written in basically in this output folder. It's here in the models, diazepam liver model. And what is generated are basically two files. The one is the SPML file, which has the XML extension here, and then an HTML report, which gives an overview of the model. So what is in the SPML is basically XML, and there we see a lot of this list. This is list of unit definitions, list of compartments we have in the list of species, and also this list of ports, which is for the model coupling later. And it's basically we see these objects which we created here in or defined here in code are now really existing in the SPML model. What we have in addition is basically this HTML report, which we can look at in a browser, and it gives a bit of searchable overview what we have in the model. So what we have in there is mainly this is our model overview. We have a lot of ports, a lot of unit definitions, and then we have two constant compartments and four species which are in the compartments and have like some initial concentration of zero. Okay, so this is basically the first model version. If we would have defined something wrong, we would get error messages in the model creation. For instance, I could just here have a typo in something in the compartments or something like that, and if I then execute it, I will get I will get error in the model creation. And it basically gives one like hints what could have gone wrong. Like for instance here, we only created a liver compartment, liver one, but yeah, of course now this species DS refers to a compartment which is not defined because we didn't define the four liver compartment. Same for the other compartment and so on. And exactly same problems here for the liver and liver. So if you actually do something wrong here, then most of the time you will get here red and some hints, okay, what could have gone wrong in the model. Okay, so but now the model is okay. So next step we normally do, like it's basically like having a very basic model, but then step by step we adding new objects to this model and make this more complicated and adding reactions, for instance, for the conversion and so on. What is very helpful for me always is like having like basically the SPML file, this HTML report to check a bit what is in there, especially because it's also you can basically search in this report a bit. Interactively, like what is DIARTS, and see, okay, this is only filtered to what is related to DIARTS, and we see here it's like this four species which are related to that. It allows easily to navigate a bit and find things in the model. For instance, yeah, here nothing was found. Okay, this is the one thing. The next thing we're doing normally is like visualizing the model with Cytoscape. And for that, we install Cytoscape and the SciSPML plugin, and then we can load this model. So we just start Cytoscape. And this looks basically like this. And what we get is here a panel with a SciSPML where we can then load models, validate SPML models, and so on. Look at a few examples and basically figure out what is going on with these models. So what I normally do, you can just drag and drop the network files in here. So I will just drag and drop this model we now created in there to visually inspect what we have so far. So it's basically here from the models we created here. This model I can just drag and drop in here, and then it will be loaded. Okay, the important thing I would say is here that you on the left see always like different networks which are generated, and there are two networks which like basically contain a lot of information. It's like this all network, and also this kinetic network. They basically also include information about ports and units and so on. Here in this case, in units also. And then there's a space model, which is basically giving an overview about the reaction species graph we have here. Basically, what we have here, like we're just seeing two kind of nodes which are colored differently. The one is the extern here. It's basically the things which are in the external compartment. They are in blue. And then we have in red the internal or liver species. That's why I added here also the liver to the name. This still looks very easy to navigate with this model because it's a very simple model, but the more complicated this gets, the larger these graphs are getting, and then this can be very helpful to see if something was created incorrectly or also to filter information out of this network. So this was basically the species, and now we would just create the next model version by adding this demethylation step to the model. For that, we again look back at information we have. In this case, we know it's a demethylation. I'm not sure if we have a bit more information. I just have to see if I already put something here. Drug-drug interactions, disease, kinetics. Yeah, we have to look a bit at the kinetics if we have information. For instance, what we have here is like from some paper we have some recombinant information. If we use diazepam, how this conversion is approximately, and like some information about Km values, approximate Km values, which is very helpful, like to just have a first approximate value for the Km values. For instance, here, this looks a lot, I don't know, like around 100, 150 or something for the diazepam, for the TMZ formation. In fact, the TMZ is probably the, now we have to just figure out if this is the right TMZ. It's probably it's probably a synonym for this desmethyl diazepam. Okay, let's see if we have more microsome kinetics. Okay. Okay. Temazepam, Nordiazepam. These are basically the... Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is Temazepam, Tumeinor, Oxazepam. This is probably the Temazepam here. Let's see, Temazepam, Tiazentismetil. Here we have something. Computer-Vasofemax. Temazepam. Desmetylcer. Okay, and here. Okay, this is okay. We have something, I don't know, 180 micromolar, something like this. This looks also, yeah, this looks okay. So we will use basically this values of something 150, 180 for now to define the KM values. Okay. Okay, this makes more sense in a second when we write down the reaction equations for the model. So what we're doing now is that we have our species. What we now have to add is basically the reactions to the model. And for that, we're creating a new reaction. Need a name for that. This is like a hydroxylation. But we probably have to check back if we have one or two. Hydroxylations, it's always demethylation. Okay, demethylation. Diazepam. Okay, so we call this here just demethylation. That's basically the ID, and then we also give a name. Methylation. And then we need basically a reaction equation to say what is converted into what, and the kinetics of to define how fast are the rates for that. So the equation is basically what is converted to what. In our case, it's diazepam is converted to desmethyl diazepam. So this is the internal reaction diaz. It's converted to DM diaz. That's the equation. We write the SPO term. So what kind it is? In this case, it's a biochemical reaction. And then we need a basically a formula. And formula. Okay, so I have to look up how to do that. A formula. You can always look at the other models in the other folders if you basically have to look something up. That's what I'm most of the time doing. It's basically if you have a reaction, exactly what do we need? We need a formula. And we have to define additional parameters. So, but I will try to write this. So what we need, okay, we need a formula string and and units. And the units are always like for reactions, it's amount per time. Now our amount is millimole. So we have like some millimole per time unit here. So we need some millimole, in this case per minute. So reactions are always in amounts per time because they take the species and they convert the species in each other. And the species have the substance amounts, which are millimole, and the a reaction is always like this differential equation of changing the species over time. So it has to be amount per time. What we need in addition are some parameters which we can put in a list. But this should probably be formula. What did I do wrong? Let's see. Okay, this looks good, but we need pass parameters, which is a list, and now we need the parameters which we have in this kinetic equation. In this simple formula, we just set this constant to a given Vmax value. In this case, we just have to define this parameter. And so we give an ID. This is the ID of the parameter. This was a Vmax value. We have to give a value. We just give 1.0 and what else do we need? A unit. So in the unit is of course also millimole per minute. That's it. We have to define if this is constant. This is normally constant. True. Yes. And if you want, we can give an SPO term. In this case, I have to see if we have one for that. Oh. Maximal velocity, we even have one. Okay. So this would be basically adding a reaction by giving the equation and defining the formula. And the formula, of course, can depend on parameters, which we also have to define. Okay, we try to create this model now. Okay, now we see here, you get errors. We see here, for instance, this Vmax is not the ID of a species compartment, and it's pretty sure we did a typo, because we call this here Vmax. No, this is the wrong model, sorry. It's a palm liver. We call this here Vmax, and our parameter, which is defined as Vmax. So this should fix it. Okay. If you have a new model version, can import that again. But we see now that we basically this got a bit more complicated, and in addition, we to the external species, we now have a diazepam demethylation reaction inside of the liver. This one. But this is not very useful yet because we first don't have it connected to the external compounds in the plasma or blood. And of course, this reaction is not yet very, very useful. So this would be the next two things we are updating, basically creating an import and an export reaction. And then also making this kinetics a bit more complicated. So what we normally have is Michaelis-Menten-like kinetic. Most of this drug metabolism is irreversible. So we need a type of kinetic which is basically irreversible kinetics, and mostly this is Michaelis-Menten kinetic. So we just add this Michaelis-Menten part to the equation. In this case, it's just the concentration, and the concentration is basically the diazepam via the Km parameter, which is giving the half maximal value of the reaction saturation plus the actual concentration. So this is basically just a modulation of the reaction. And of course we have, this was wrong. I did it in the parameter, not in the formula. So this of course has to be the formula here. And the parameter is of course the Vmax parameter. Of course we need now a second parameter, like the diaz is defined, as a metabolite, but our CAM parameter does not exist yet. So we define the CAM here and set this to something like the 150 micromolar. So the unit we're using for CAM values normally is millimolar. Set this to Michaelis constant. The unit is millimolar, so we want micromolar, so we have to go to 150 micromolar. This is basically what we saw in this experiment. This is this half saturation. So the KM is normally giving on the half saturation. So now we have here a bit more complicated kinetics with the saturation, and this additional parameter gives one the half saturation. Now that this is working, the units must of course be correct. So this diazepam 4 max already has the correct units of millimole per minute, and the KM has a unit of millimolar, and the diazepam also has a unit of millimolar. And this comes from basically the species definition. We're defining what are the substance units, these are the amount units, and via this additional flag we can define if this is measured in amounts or measured in concentrations. And if this is in as the flag false, as only substance units false, then this is measured in concentrations. So all our things here has only substance units false are all in concentrations. So this results in basically incorrect units here. Exactly. So this would be the first step, making this kinetics a bit more complicated. And the second thing we have to do is basically creating transport reactions for our two substances, that they're coming from the outside, the external compartment in the liver compartment. So we will have some diazepam import. This is now a reversible reaction, and can basically import the external diazepam into the liver diazepam. This is now a transport reaction, but has a similar structure than this Michaelis-Menten kinetic. The only difference now is that these are reversible kinetics. Reversible Michaelis-Menten kinetics, so we need a bit more complicated equation here. So basically what happens is that this transport rates normally depend on the concentration gradient of these two substances over the membrane. So if diazepam external is bigger or larger than diazepam, this has a positive value. And this is running in positive reaction. It's running in basically in positive direction, this reaction. And if diazepam intern is bigger than the diazepam extern, this will have negative values and will reverse the reaction. The first part, and then you have to normalize this via some KM values. And this is basically the concentration over the KM values. So the one is the diaz over the respective KM value. Of course, we need now some new parameters here, or import parameters. 150 is okay. And using this parameters in here, diaz import M value plus and here's external KM value. It's basically the definition of an reversible Michaelis-Menten kinetic. The only thing which is not correct right now is the units. Basically what we have down here in the denominator is something which is dimensionless. This part is dimensionless. The concentrations via the KMs are dimensionless because both are in millimolar. This is also dimensionless, so the denominator is dimensionless, but here this difference has the units of of our species, which is millimolar, because they are in concentrations. So the whole thing has basically a concentration too much. And we this is normally done by normalizing the Vmax value via all the Km values we have. In this case, it's only one. So we'll leave this here incorrect, just to show something in the graph later on. But this is basically the import. And let's see if we did this correct. Yeah, this is working, and we can again visualize this Cytoscape now and see what happened with this additional things we modeled. Okay, what we see now, okay, we have like basically additional reactions in here. Like now the blood compartment is imported by our import reactions. In red, obviously the irreversible reactions, in black are the reversible reactions. So in this case, this import is reversible. We did this via this reversible Michaelis-Menten kinetic. It can go in both directions, meaning it can have negative flux, and also the diazepam in the liver can be exported again. And then we have this second reaction. What we did wrong is basically the connection of this one Vmax value. And we will see this easily in this kinetic part. You basically look at that, you will see often, like if you see this isolated parameters or isolated objects in this graph, you know something went wrong and it's not connected. But it's just showing the kinetic thing is basically giving you a connection graph of all the formulas and the mathematics you have in the model. And so like what it means that things are not connected, it basically means this parameter is not really used. It's a bad sign, and it means most likely we did a wrong Vmax value. We can see that we did it wrong because basically this Vmax value for the DM, it's connected to here, to two kinetic laws. And this should not be the case. We basically did one of the connections wrong here in the model building. And this is basically only, it's possible to see this on a graphic basis, on a graphical basis here, but it's not possible to really see this in the kinetics, because everything is mathematically correct and from the units correct, but the mathematics is not correct because the connection of the importer is basically using the wrong parameter here. Okay, but basically this should fix it. And the only thing which is missing for this very simple model is basically having an export reaction in the end of the product we are creating. And this is very similar to the import, but we want, of course, to export the dimethyl diazepam. We making this exporter, okay. Dimethyl, let's see. What do we call this? Dimethyl diazepam. This material, diazepam export. And this is basically exporting the things. So it's using the desmethyl diazepam internally, and it can export it reversibly to the desmethyl diazepam extern. It's also transport reaction. This is correct. And now we have to be careful to use the right variables. So I will just replace this all. Basically, these three have to be replaced, and these two also have to replace. And this is basically the export reaction. The only important thing now is to have the directions correctly. Because we defined this as an exporter, you always have to make sure that this gradient of concentration gradient is defined correctly. Here we want to have a positive flux if it's an export. An export is achieved if we have an internal concentration which is larger than the external concentration. especially here that the import is defined in the importers and exporters are defined in different directions. So let's see if this works. No, yet extern is not listed off DM. Okay, let's see. There's an error, DM, DS, okay. The species DS extern is not listed as product in DM DS extern. That means, of course, yeah, what we did wrong in this case, we didn't use the right substances here. We defined in the equations we want to have that, but the validation finds, okay, in our equation, we're not using the correct substances here. So let's basically fix it. Now we, DS extern is not listed, blah, 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 DM DS. Ah, yeah, of course, and here I have to do it everywhere in the equation. This makes sense. And then we basically have also the additional export reaction. Okay, and this, yeah, just a quick check that this created the right model. We can now see, okay, we now really have the full cycle. It's imported, it's the reaction takes place, and then it can be exported again. Okay, so basically from the graph and so on, and now I will use a simple tool, visual tool, to make a simple simulation just to show that we can simulate the model. I will use Copasi for that, which allows to easily load. Do I have Copasi? No, which allows to load and simulate such models. Okay, how does it work? Basically, we have to go to copasi.org and just download it. Ah, there, I have it already. Download it, install it. And then we started Copasi. And one second. Okay, and then we just started it. What we can do now is just import the simple model and see if we can do a simple simulation with that. For that, we just can do file, import SPML. We now have the standard format, which we can use in different tools. And so we can import the models. And yet the power model here. And have this basically loaded. What we see here, what we also have, like, is two compartments. We see this is our things we have, our four species we have, three reactions we have. We can now easily run like some time course simulation. Okay, via tasks, time courses, and then I have to create some outputs first. Here we'll do like some simple concentration plots. And then we can basically model this whole system for, I don't know, here, can just do 5 hours, 300 minutes. Define the number of time steps, 1000 in this case, and can then just set some additional integration settings, but basically then simulate it. Okay, so, and this is how we see our four species, but it all looks very, very boring. And this is to expect because, of course, we didn't set any initial concentrations on the model. Everything is zero at the beginning. And for something interesting to happen, at least we should probably give some DS at the beginning. So we will do do this and change just our initial concentrations here in the model for our diazepam, the external, and can give like some certain concentrations, one millimolar, and then do another time course simulation with that. And then we see, okay, the whole thing is already much more interesting. Okay, we have a bit the time scaling is here wrong. So it's very fast what we built here as a model. So I will just simulate it for the first 10 minutes. But this is basically defined by the Vmax values, which define how fast this is running. Let's run now. Where's my plot? Where are my plots? Here. Okay. We can at least visually check. First thing we see here, we probably have not enough data points, which is why it's here a bit sketchy. This normally doesn't mean that the indicator is so sketchy, but it just means we don't have enough time points here. Yeah, probably we need more like 300 or something time points. Let me see, this all looks much more smooth. Does it make sense what happens here? Like basically our diazepam extern, yeah, it's this curve. It's just going down exponentially. What happens then? We get some diazepam in the liver here. This appears, and the diazepam is then converted to desmethyldiazepam in the liver. Makes also sense. This appears, and then it's exported and goes outside. And so after here 5 minutes with this model, all our diazepam is now converted to desmethyldiazepam and exported. So this was pretty fast. Other simple things we can do with that is what Quasi is pretty good for is doing things like simple parameter scans. So we could here just do a scan, a new scan of some of our global quantities, it should be. Exactly, we can just scan one of the parameters, and for instance, we could just scan our reaction rate for the demethylation. Here, this Vmax value, we could just scan that. We set this to 1 right now. We can just, for instance, logarithmically scan this from 0.01. And here, logarithmically, we can go really high. Just scan this, do 10 things, and then just run this, and we'll then see, okay, how this Vmax value is changing the simulation results. We see, depending on the Vmax values, these curves are like faster or much, much slower. For instance, yeah, we see like this is basically going against like some boundary here and against some boundary here. And correspondingly, the desmethyldiazepam will appear again and see how this curves can change depending on the parameters. So for this, Quasi is really, really good. I can recommend this to play basically a bit with the models to get a feeling for the kinetics. But later on, we will really simulate this in Python with Roadrunner and the SPML sim tools. Exactly. And this is basically how you would create such a simple model. Next things we would do is basically, or things you should do now is basically extend this model to include the additional reactions which we need in the liver. It's the additional kinetics here. We just modeled like one of the conversions. Of course, there are more substances in there, two additional, the methyl oxazepam, the oxazepam, and this additional reactions which we need for the conversions. It's basically three additional reactions, two additional species, and exactly to extend this model. And of course, we have to couple this whole model, the tissue model of the liver, then to the whole body model. I would say this is basically how to build such model. It's in the beginning, it's you have to get a bit used to, okay, how is the syntax, how to define this reaction species and so on. But I would say if you have seen this a few times, then it's pretty intuitive how to add this. Okay, I think this is the main information for now. You should get this running locally on your computer and also get Cytoscape installed and have a look at the SPML models and try in Coparse to run and simulate this models too. Basically, just check a bit what is happening. Okay. I will just one second. Stop share. And